A/B testing your Amazon product creatives can significantly increase your conversion rates. There are two ways to do split tests, either with Amazon's Manage Experiments tool or third-party tools like Pickfu. In this video, you will learn the differences between these two options and which one might work better for you. And in case you would like to get Amazon creatives made for you or run A/B tests for your current ones, you will find some of our recommendations and special offers in the video description below.
Hi Daniela, I'm really excited to have you back on Orange Klik YouTube channel. And today we have a very interesting topic we're gonna dive into, which is split testing on and off Amazon. And also we're going to try to understand what kind of different tests Amazon sellers can do and which test is good for what. But as always, before we go into the details, could you first introduce yourself and also let us know what Mindful Goods is doing and how do you help Amazon sellers?
Sure. Thanks for having me back on again. My name is Daniela Bolzmann. I'm the founder of Mindful Goods, where we have been optimizing product pages and storefronts for e-commerce brands on Amazon for the last 7 years. And I think you'll see some amazing examples of that today.
Very cool. And I'm really happy to have you to talk about split testing because I think you are very known in Amazon space for providing case studies, which are backed with data. So it's not just your opinion or your team's opinion, but actually everything is backed by the real results. I know you prepared a presentation for us to kind of walk us through everything. So go ahead, share a screen and let's dive into it.
All right. So a little bit about us before we jump into this topic is that we have specialists across 8 different countries. We've been optimizing content for Amazon for 7 years, and we've worked with over 500 brands. We're also an Amazon service provider, certified service provider network member. We've also been featured by Amazon, and some of the lovely things that Amazonians are saying about us is that we are some of the most gifted in the world at creating content for Amazon. So to get into this topic of split testing, we first have to just really quickly get down to the basics. Like, what is split testing? Split testing is just showing 2 versions of content. It's also called A/B testing. And by showing those 2 different versions of contents to shoppers, we can understand which one is going to perform better. Now, there's a 5-step process that I created for our team to basically run these tests. And this is how we end up building our case studies and why we've seen such insane results, which I will share with you in just a moment. But there's 5 very simple steps that we're going to walk through. The first is researching and ideating, then running your external testing. Then we're going to iterate based on that knowledge. Then we're going to run an internal test, and then we're going to go live with the winners. And then we're going to repeat the whole thing all over again. So it's really important that we understand that 1 test is not enough. 3 tests might not be enough. It's all about this cycle that we need to keep doing. And it's just these 5 steps over and over and over again. So, the thing we need to understand is that there's 2 different types of testing, and we're going to cover these in depth today. And I'm actually going to show you live examples really quick of how you would do these so that you really get a clear understanding of why this is working for our clients. So an external test for us is something we do for iteration. It's not something that is actually validated with true Amazon data. It's something you use in the design process to help you understand or have an indication of whether your design thinking is working or whether your data in your designs is working. And so we use tools like Pickfu, Product Pinion, and IntelliV to kind of understand just at a really quick high level, are we trending in the right direction with our data? Are shoppers liking this new design better than the former design? Yes or no? Now, once we have that, we can then do some adjustments and then go move over to an internal test. And for me, the reason why I call it internal tests for design validation is because this is where we're actually getting true data from Amazon. We're testing inside of the Amazon platform, and we're letting Amazon tell us whether it's truly working or not. So just remember, there's 2 types of testing for split testing. Now, to show you a visual example of why this matters, is like the external design might look something like this, where we're just getting a quick number, we're getting some respondents telling us about the test that we're running, which one they favor. So you can see here, this one's the winner, versus something like this, where we're letting Amazon just run it in the background, and they will give us actual statistical data to let us know the true performance of this split test. So the reason why this is so important, and the reason why we do this for every single client that we work with, is that we believe that this is what is creating results. Testing your content over and over and over again is what's creating organic growth for brands on Amazon, especially for e-commerce brands. So since 2023, we've completed over 137 split tests. This is a mix between manager experiments and manual pulling of data. Over 78.6% of clients saw an increase in sales. That means that 78% of clients, by running these tests and updating their content, they're seeing an increase in sales. For main images, we have an 87% performance rate, meaning that most of the time our main images are winning over the client's main image. So what you can glean from that is there's probably a lot that you can do with your main image. A plus content as well. You'll see our before and after as we do drastic changes to A plus content. So it's no surprise that we're seeing results there. And then title tests, you see the lowest amount of improvements, but there's a very clear reason for that. It's because most brands have usually updated their title and it's the easiest thing to do really quickly. So we might not see as many gains, but clients should definitely invest in their title. The other thing that our clients are seeing is that 50% of our clients see anywhere from $5,000 to $120,000 increase in revenue. And the best case scenario that they'd be seeing is up to $205,000 in increased revenue over that next year after updating their content. And usually we're running 2 to 3 tests for our clients and we're updating title, bullets, main image, A plus content. So you can generally assume that if you're an e-commerce brand and you make updates to all of those things, you should be seeing this kind of benchmark. So what are the types of testing that we can do on Amazon? Amazon has a tool called Manager Experiments. Like I mentioned before, we can test main image. We can test the whole product image stack. We can test title. We can test bullets, brand story, A plus content. But the biggest question for this, all of these different types of tests, is which one can generate the most sales? Where do we start, right? And this is one of the top questions that I get because everybody just wants to tackle the lowest hanging fruit. Our data actually shows that titles have the highest impact on sales. So if you are watching this, as much as I want to help you with your designs, I highly encourage you to test your titles. You should be able to adjust your title and test it today if you wanted to. Beyond that, so the titles are showing up to 589% increase in sales. They're showing massive increases in sessions. If you've already tackled that or you think you've done a good enough job, you might be encouraged to move on to the A plus content testing, which is our next highest. Brands are seeing up to 358% increase in sales. But I caution you here because A plus content is actually the heaviest lift of everything, meaning it's going to take more time. It's going to take more resources. You might not do it right. And so there's more risk involved with A plus content. So it's just something that when you do, you should be doing well. Main images are the other low hanging fruit after titles and bullets. You can see up to 160% increase in your main images. And the reason why I encourage you to test this second after your titles is because it is the lightest lift. It is, I'm going to show you how I would do it in Canva, and then you can give that Canva to your designer to polish it off. And we're going to go through that exercise today live really quickly. So some of the results that clients are seeing from these exact split tests, from these exact content refreshes, are like Akasha Superfoods increasing their sales by 589%, like Pop Chips doubling their conversion rate across their catalog, like Rusty's improving their sales by 181%, and then Iwi Life also seeing a 559% increase. And again, this is in some of these cases, it's actually one or two tests. In some of these cases, it's one, two, or three. So adding them all up is where it gets even higher and higher and higher, right? So let's move on to step one, researching and ideating. So here, what we're trying to do is basically come up with at least two concepts. And so let's say we were starting with a main image. We're going to use the main image as the example for this webinar. We want to basically research ideas within our category, so snack bars. And then we might want to research outside of our category. So maybe checking like chili sauce or other things, like what are other people doing? What are other really on-trend products right now? If we're working in the food category, what are the on-trend products that we can look at and see what are they doing in the search results? How are they getting clicks? How are they getting attention? What are the ideas? And just there is no wrong idea here. As long as you're within terms of service, you want to just be open to all of these ideas. So what I see when I look at this is I see the bar standing up on the packaging, but then I see it laying across. So that's catching my eye. I'm seeing the brand Kind really big, really big. I'm seeing certain words like snack size really big. I'm seeing in all of these examples, the bar is either shown as a close-up really big, or they're putting the bar on the outside of the packaging. This one's creeping outside the packaging. So there's all of these different options, right? And then if we look at these Momofuku images, which is one of our former clients, what you can see here is there's a lot of play with eye candy and orientation. So we're showing the eye candy here below the packaging. We're showing these post edits call outs. So these are actually not on the packaging. This is what's called a post edit, where you take something and you put it on the photo after you took the photo. So we're putting an edit in post on top of this product, right? Here I'm playing with orientation, where I'm showing the family of product. Here we're showing the sauce. So there's lots of different elements going on here. But again, big word for soy sauce, big word for spicy seasoned salt, big word for tamari. But there's some things in common, some patterns that we can see, and some interesting tactics that you can see across each one. Okay, so if we were going to play with this live, right? I'm going to actually exit so we can actually do this together. Okay, so this is something that I wanted to do live because I want everyone to feel empowered and encouraged. You can, as the founder of your business, play with these images yourself in Canva. I generally don't recommend taking a Canva image and uploading it to Amazon unless you've really polished it off and it looks very professional. If you're a Canva novice or you're not a designer, you can then give this to your designer and have them polish it off after you've collected data in this first phase, which is more of a prototyping phase. It's just have fun, play with it, see what works, see what doesn't, right? So if we took the insights that we just saw from those previous images and we said, okay, I have a product shot of my product. I'm just gonna put it over here. I saw that there was some call outs for the bar. So let's put a big like 6 bars here. Maybe I wanna show this on the side. Maybe I don't, maybe it doesn't really work. Maybe this word needs to be bigger for like black sesame sea salt. So I can just kind of play around with this and see if I can get it to be even bigger. And, you know, you can remove the background here just by clicking here, remove background. And then, well, then you would see the previous one, I believe. But then it might blend a little better. But you can see this is not a polished design, right? This is not something that we would upload to Amazon. But it's something that we can play around with in here. We can say, okay, what if we twisted this a little bit just to get some attention? Let's move this out of the way. And so maybe this could be our main image just by playing around with this and seeing if we can get these elements to do something more interesting than what we had. Like just, we don't want just a box. We want a box. We want to know what the callouts are. Usually when you're developing these callouts, it's good to look at your keywords and understand what are the things the shoppers are actually searching for in relation to my product. So if we know that they're searching for the word snack bar, we want the word snack bar to show up here. And here it's on the packaging, but maybe we would want to make that a little bit bigger. You know, if we know that a mom is shopping for a variety pack for her kids or for snack size bars for her kids' lunch boxes, then you might want to call out the word snack pack or snack sizes or something like that on top of the packaging. So it's really important that you review the keyword data to understand what people are actually searching for in relation to your specific product. And you can definitely add those as post edits, as call outs, just like this. All right, so let's get back into presenting mode here. We'll keep going. So the second part of this test is to test in a tool like PicFu or Product Pinion. And the reason why I recommend using a tool like PicFu or Product Pinion is because we need quick data. We need to understand, is this working or is it not? And in both of these tools, you can pick 50 Prime, Amazon Prime member shoppers, who maybe even those who have kids, if you wanted to search, you know, for moms, you can even search by demographic, by college educated, all of these different factors, right, that you might know about your particular avatar for your customer. If you don't want to do that, you can just do a wider audience, which is still totally fine. Some data is better than no data in this scenario, right? So these tools will show these two images to your clients or to your shoppers. And then they'll have a chance to vote on it and give you some quantitative and qualitative data. So you'll know which one is the clear winner, and then you'll see the insights and exactly what they wrote. And the reason why this is so important is because, like, let's use the example of Yes Bar. What we noticed in that pattern was that people were mentioning, like, they were asking the same question over and over again about, is this vegan, is this vegan, is this vegan? Well, let's go look at the keyword data. The keyword data is also suggesting that people are searching for vegan snack bars. Well, guess what? Yes Bar does have a few options that are vegan. And for those specific options, we want to make sure we highlight that on the main image. So when they're searching for vegan snack bar, vegan is one of those top words, right? So these are the kind of insights that help you validate your design along the way. The third step, once you have all of that data from Product Pinion or PicFu, you can then look at the data and say, okay, we need to highlight the word vegan, or we need to make the box bigger, or people were confused, they didn't know what flavor this was. Like, those are the things that you can clarify in your design and make it better. So at that point, you take those insights, you take your prototype, you give it to your designer, you let them polish it off, and it looks something like this, right? Where we have, okay, we have a beautiful box, it's high res, and then you might even look at this and say, okay, but what happens now that we have this finalized design? What if we punch up the color here? So you see this word yes is a little bit lighter than this one. We're punching it up, we're making it brighter, because again, we want to draw attention, we want to get the clicks from the search results. What happens if we add the six bars? What happens if we don't add the six bars? This is, these are two very valid finalized designs that we now have from our designer that now we can upload to our next step in the process, which is manage your experiments. And so this is the free tool that Amazon created for brands to be able to upload both their options, test it, and get back data just like this to understand whether it's working or not. This is some of the results that you would see. You would see a best case scenario of what your, so you would see all of this data here, right? You would see what your conversions look like. You would see how much incremental sales you're getting from this updated image. It'll tell you very clearly which version is best, version A or version B. The thing that I'm not the biggest fan of with manager experiments is it does take a lot of time. It can take 4 to 10 weeks, which is a bummer, but there are other ways to test. So the good thing about Amazon experiments is it's giving you the projections. So you're able to see exactly what the best case scenario is for your sales and what the most likely scenario is for your sales. So this is basically, if you did nothing today besides changing that image, you're most likely going to see $52,000 come to you over the next, an incremental $52,000 over the next year. If you boosted that with a little bit of PPC and you're doing other testing, you could see up to $143,000 in increased revenue. So this is Amazon showing you, like, this is the potential of this image right now based on your category. Okay, so the other type of alternative testing, because not everybody qualifies for manager experiments, you have to have enough sessions coming to your listing. And then Amazon takes only a certain percentage of those sessions for your test. It doesn't test across all of your sessions. So if you do not qualify, one thing you can do is you can upload just that element, an isolated test. Basically, don't change anything else on your listing. Don't change your PPC. Don't add a coupon. Don't change anything else on your listing for the next 15 to 30 days. What you're going to do is review the last 30 to 90 days to see what your average sessions were, your average conversion rate, and then you're going to compare that against the next 2 weeks to 4 weeks manually. You're going to go and pull that data. The other option is that you can use a tool like Jungle Ace. So if you are running PPC and you want to expedite the speed of which you're running your tests and you want to do that faster than manager experiments, Jungle Ace allows you to tap into your PPC campaigns, run it within a week, and then understand what's winning and what's not. So another really great option. Okay, so the step number 5 is the one everyone's been waiting for. You're going to go ahead and publish your results. But the key thing here that I want everybody to remember is that you should rinse and repeat. Always be testing. An example of this, and the reason why this is so important, is our single best test generated a 600% increase in orders off of one single test. Our best performing content overall generated a 783% increase in sales. That's across title, bullets, everything. But usually it takes a minimum of 3 tests like this to be able to see these kinds of results. So don't stop at 1 test. Don't even stop at 3 tests. Put together a plan for the year to be testing throughout the year. And that is our split testing webinar for today.
Very cool, Dania. Thank you so much. And here's also your contact information so sellers can reach out to you if they have any questions about this video or would like to learn more about your services. So Daniela, I know that you are talking with a lot of Amazon sellers on a daily basis because you also work with sellers. So what do you think are, do you meet like a lot of experienced sellers who are still not yet into A/B testing, or is in general the situation in a way that most sellers are already A/B testing, whether it's internally on Amazon or externally by using the additional tools?
That's a really great question. So a majority of the clients that we serve are e-commerce brands. So they already have their Shopify websites. They're already very familiar with split testing on their direct-to-consumer websites, or familiar with what it is at least, but they're not familiar with the Amazon landscape and how to do it on Amazon. And so usually that's why brands are coming to us, so that we're giving them the full package at once. For years, we were giving clients multiple titles. We were giving them multiple main images. And when we would go back and ask them, how did your tests go? 0% of them had actually tested. Even though we gave them the preliminary data from PicFu, they just hadn't tested. So at this point, we do that as a courtesy to clients that work with us. We do run those tests for them because we too want to know whether it's working so we can adjust content, right? So that's the best practice. And then the other thing that we're going to be rolling out soon is actually annual testing. So we're going to be running split testing across the catalog. We've been doing this for just a few clients to start. So it's very much in a pilot mode, but there are more brands that are a little bit further along that are looking to be testing throughout the year so they can get those incremental gains as they go.
Okay, sounds really good. And to wrap up today's interview, can you once more highlight what are the main services you offer for Amazon sellers? How do you help them, and with what type of brands do you usually work together with?
Yeah, so if you're an e-commerce brand, it doesn't matter if you're an early stage e-commerce brand or a $10 million or $50 million e-commerce brand, we've worked with them all. We are here to help you specifically with your content optimization for Amazon. So we will do glow ups on your product page, on your storefront, and we'll help you with that split testing to make sure that it's working.
Okay, and we're going to have the link to the website in the video description below, but if you can tell us what's the website and also what's the best address to reach you if anyone wants to learn more about the services.
Yeah, head over to mindfulgoods.co, that's .co, and you can reach me at Daniela@mindfulgoods.co.
Okay, awesome. Well, thank you so much, Daniela, for putting together the presentation for us and educating our community. And if you have any questions for Daniela about A/B testing, then leave a comment down below and we're going to ask Daniela to come back to the video as well. So thanks again, and I hope to see you soon.
I hope this video will help you to improve your listing creatives that will drive more sales. If you need help with product images and overall listing optimization, reach out to Daniela and her team at Mindful Goods. Find the link below in the description and use the exclusive 10% discount. Also, if you have additional questions about A/B testing your creatives, leave them in the comment section below. And of course, as always, don't forget to hit the like and subscribe buttons. And now I recommend you to check out this video where you will learn step by step how to use PicFu for A/B tests. So check this out.